Hello, my name is Cal, and in today's tutorial we're going to be building a recycler view of recycling in Android Studio using Java. So in the first part of the video we're going to build the recycler view, so we're going to build the grid layout and populate the list so that you can scroll up and down and look at your recycler view that way. In the second half of the video we're going to implement the onClick method and the onClick listener so that when you click on each one of the squares, it takes you to a more detailed view of that square. There's a link in the description to all of the source code. There's a link in the description to the images, so if you want to download them, feel free.
So just opened up Android Studio and I'm creating a new Android Studio project. I'm calling this recyclerview example. And then I'm just going to start by importing my images. So I'm just right clicking on that drawable folder there and I'm showing it in Explorer and then copy and pasting all my images across like that. And then I'm just going to say file, new, activity, and I'm just going to call this detail activity. And then I'm just going to say go into our layout folder here, so make sure that's selected, and then I'm just going to say file, new, resource file, and I'm going to call this recycle cell. And make sure this is all lowercase and you use the underscore there because it's a layout file, so it has to be, that's the naming convention. And then I'm just going to say new Java class, I'm calling this recycle adapter, and then I'm going to say file, new Java class again. And I'm going to call this recycling, which doesn't have an E there. I couldn't work out how to spell recycling. So anyway, that's my recycling class. And then I'm going to get our layout sorted first. So I'm just going to head back into our main activity layout file. And then I'm just going to say Android X recycler view. And then I need to import this dependency here. So just click on that. Error message there and import that dependency, and then I'm just going to say the height and the width match parent, and I'm just giving it an ID. Alright, let's get our recycler view, let's get our recycle cell working now. So just going to change that to a relative layout there, and I'm just going to say wrap content and wrap content on that main relative layout. I'm just going to set the orientation to vertical, and then I'm going to add in our image view. I'm going to say wrap content for both the width and the height. I'm going to say scale type is fit to start. Adjust view bounds to true. I'm going to give it a bit of padding. I'm going to give it an ID of recycle cell image. And I'm also just going to give it a source just so you can see what's happening. This will get overridden, but just for now, it kind of looks nice there in that right hand side. And then I'm just going to add a text view. I'm just going to say wrap content on the width and the height is 50 dp. And I'm just going to rename the ID to recycle cell text. Got to put the ID in there. And then I'm going to say gravity is center vertical. And I'm going to say layout center horizontal is true. It's a bit of a funny way to do that. Gravity center vertical and layout center horizontal true. But that's just the two ways you can go about doing that. And then I'm just going to say it's below our recycle cell image always. And I'm going to give it some placeholder text so you can see what it looks like. And I'm just going to make the text a little bit bigger, so 30 sp on that there. And then I'm just going to copy and paste the whole thing, and I'm going to put it in our detail activity because it's going to be pretty much the same thing. So just copy and paste that in there, and just change the width and the height of that relative layout to match parent, so it takes up the whole screen no matter what. And then I'm just going to rename the IDs of the ID, and then I will have to just change that layout below because we've changed the ID there. Cool, and then I'm going to get our class sorted. So our recycling class is going to have an ID, which is a string. It's going to have a name, which is a string. And it's going to have an int, which is going to be our image, or at least a pointer to our image. And then I'm going to add one more string called type. And then I'm just going to right-click. I'm going to say generate constructor. And I'm going to highlight all and just hit OK. So I've got a constructor there. And then I'm going to say generate once again, getter and setter, highlight them all. And that's just a nice, quick, easy way to make a class. And then I'll just make it public and static. Well, not static, just public. And then I'm just going to say, go into our recycleadapter class, and I'm going to say, our recycleadapter extends recyclerview.adapter, and then I'm going to implement all of those methods. Cool, and so inside our recycleadapter class, I'm actually going to create another class. I'm going to call this viewholder, and it's going to extend recyclerview.viewholder. And then I'm just going to implement a constructor there, so viewholder. And then I'm just going to declare an image view and our text view. And I'm just going to find both of those by their ID. So recycle image is encastered to an image view, and then item view dot find view by ID. And then I'm giving it that recycle cell image and recycle cell text. So those ones we created in our recycle cell. And then I'm just going to head back up to the top of our recycler adapter class, and I'm going to declare a new array list of recycling. I'm going to call it recycling array list and create a constructor for that as well. And then in our view holder on create view holder, I'm just going to say view is equal to layout inflator dot from parent dot get context dot inflate. And then I'm going to say r dot layout recycle cell. So give it our recycle cell and then give it our parent and attach to root false. And then I'm just going to return a new view holder of our view. So a bit of an amendment here. So we've actually created our own custom view holder. So I need to make this type of our own custom view holder. So you can see that's our recycle adapter.view holder, which is the one we created down below. And then I'm going to recreate, I'll re-implement that method, that onBind view holder method. And then I'm just going to say holder.recycleImage.setImageResource, recyclingArrayList.getAtPosition. So you see that's passing in a position. And then I'm going to get the image based on that position out of our array list. And I just realized I can get rid of this recyclerView on that onCreateViewHolder method. It just tweaked my... but then I'm going to do the same thing for our text. So I'm just going to say holder.recycleText.setText and then get our recycling from our position and then get name. And then on getItemCount, I'm just going to give it recyclingArrayList.size. And then I'm just going to head back into our main activity now. And I'm just going to declare a recyclerView, so our main recyclerView. And then I'm going to say recyclerView is equal to recyclerView, so just casting it there, and then find its view by ID. And I'm just going to create a method here. I'm going to call it initializeList. And I'm going to head back up the top. I'm going to declare another array list of recycling, call it recyclingArrayList. And this part's not super exciting. I'm just going to populate our array list. So I'm just creating a new object of recycling. I'm calling this one can, giving it an ID of 0. I'm going to call it can, and I'm going to give it our image, so r.drawable.can, which is that one we imported earlier, and then I'm going to call its type aluminium, and then I'm just going to add our can to our recycling array list. And then I'm just going to copy and paste and do that for a bunch of stuff, so depending on whether or not you're following along exactly for me, you might already have a list populated, but anyway, so that's basically what I'm doing there. I'm just populating a list so that it's something to show in the recycler view. And then I'm actually going to go highlight this recycler view where I find this by view and extract it into a method. And I'm going to call that method setup recycler. And I'm actually going to do that after I initialize our list. So I'm just putting that below. And then I'm just going to say recycle adapter is equal to new recycle adapter, which is our custom recycle adapter class. And remember, we wanted to pass in an array list. So that's what we're doing there. We're passing in our recycling array list. And then I'm going to say recycler view.layout manager. And I'm going to say new grid manager, and I'm going to give it context and a span count of 2, so a grid with 2 rows. And then I'm just going to set our layout manager on our recycler view with our layout manager that we just created. And then I'm also going to set our adapter with our recycle adapter. So we can build and run this, and you can see we've got a populated list. You can scroll up and down. It's a grid layout of 2. But if you didn't want that, you wanted to change that, like I'm going to change this to 3 now and run that again, and you can see we didn't really have to do anything other than change that one number, and you've got a grid of 3. So that's pretty cool. Cool. So let's get our onClick working now. So I'm just going to head back into our recycle adapter, and I'm just going to make our viewholder class, which is inside our recycle adapter class. I'm going to make it implement view.onClickListener, and then I'm going to implement the method onClick. And then I'm actually going to say public interface onItemListener, and then I'm going to say void onItemClick. So take note that's inside our recycle adapter class and not inside our viewholder class. And then I'm just going to say inside our viewholder class, I'm going to say onItemListener, and I want it so that our constructor here passes in an onItemListener. And so I'm just saying this onItemListener is equal to onItemListener. So I'm just going to say itemView.setOnClickListener to this. And then in our onClick method, I'm just going to say onItemListener, onItemClick, get adapter position. Cool, so we're actually passing this onItemListener a lot in this implementation. So I'm actually just going to copy and paste that onItemListener, and in our recycle adapter, I want it to pass in an onItemListener as well. So same thing here, this onItemListener is equal to onItemListener. And then where we create our view holder, we need to not only pass in a view now, we need to pass in an onItemListener as well. Heading back to the main activity now, I'm just going to say main activity implements our recycle adapter dot on item listener, which is our interface we created, and I'm going to make it implement those methods. And then now our recycle adapter, we need to pass in an on item listener. Our class now implements our on item listener, so we can just pass in this whole class. And then in that on item click method, I'm just going to say intent detail intent is equal to new intent, and I'm just going to give it context of this, and I'm going to say we want to go to our detail activity with this intent, and then I'm just going to say detail intent dot put extra. I'm going to give it a name of position and pass it in our position. And then I just want to say start activity detail intent. And the final thing left to do is to make our detail activity actually show something. So I'm just going to go back into our cycle adapter, copy and paste those image and text views, and I'm just going to stick them in there at the top of the detail activity. I'm going to create two new methods, set up views and get recycling. And I'm just going to copy and paste this again because we're just doing the exact same thing, finding those views by ID. But instead of recycle cell image, we're just saying recycle detail image and recycle detail text. And I just need to make our recycling array list public and static so I can access it from this class. And I'm just going to declare a new recycling, calling it selected recycling. And in our get recycling method, I'm going to say intent, previous intent is equal to get intent. And I'm going to say int position is equal to previous intent and get int extra position. And I'm going to give it a default value of 0. And then I'm just going to get our selected recycling from our recycling array list. I'm going to get it by its position. And then I'm just going to, with our selected recycling, I'm just going to set the image resource and I'm going to set the text to our selected recycling name. Cool, and we've been run this now, and you can see when we click on each one of our little recycling there, you can see it takes us to the right thing. So I've just hit on water bottle, and there you are, water bottle. So yeah, we've got our on-click working and our whole recycle working. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll catch you in the next one.